हेलो एवरीवन, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी टेक एंड डिस्कस अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट चैप्टर ऑफ योर सिलेबस व्हिच इज सर्कल्स। एंड इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी डिस्कस अबाउट द सम इंपॉर्टेंट टर्म्स, जनरल टर्म्स रिलेटेड टू सर्कल्स। एंड वी डिस्कस ऑल द इंपॉर्टेंट टर्म्स लाइक कॉर्ड, बाइसेक्टर, कॉर्ड डायमीटर, रेडियस, सेगमेंट, सेक्टर, कॉन्सेंट्रिक सर्कल, कॉन्ग्रुएंट आर्क्स एंड कॉन्ग्रुएंट सर्कल्स। एंड वी क्लियर ऑल द इम्पॉर्टेंट टर्म्स रिलेटेड टू दैट टॉपिक। ओके, नाउ डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन टूडेज क्लास वी टेक एंड डिस्कस सम इम्पॉर्टेंट थ्योरम्स रिलेटेड टू सर्कल्स। एंड ऑल्सो वी टेक एंड सॉल्व सम इम्पॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस बेस्ड ऑन दैट टॉपिक। लेट्स सी, तो लेट्स सी सम इम्पॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन थ्योरम बेस्ड ऑन सर्कल्स। एंड थ्योरम इज प्रूव दैट द परपेंडिकुलर फ्रॉम द सेंटर परपेंडिकुलर from the center, prove that the perpendicular from the center of a circle to a chord bisects the chord. डियर स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज द वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट थ्योरम्स ऑफ द चैप्टर सर्कल। एंड देर आर सो मैनी क्वेश्चन बेस्ड ऑन दैट थ्योरम इन आवर चैप्टर, इन दैट चैप्टर। नाउ वी हैव टू शो दैट डियर स्टूडेंट, द परपेंडिकुलर ड्रॉन फ्रॉम द सेंटर ऑफ अ सर्कल टू द कॉर्ड बाइसेक्ट्स द कॉर्ड। तो इन दैट क्वेश्चन फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल डियर स्टूडेंट्स, विड्रा अ सर्कल विथ सेंटर ओ, एंड ऑल्सो वी ड्रा अकॉर्ड बिकॉज ऑफ इन दैट थ्योरम वी ड्रा द परपेंडिकुलर फ्रॉम द सेंटर ऑफ अ सर्कल टू द अकॉर्ड ना। तो लेट अस टेक टू पॉइंट्स ए एंड बी ऑन द सर्कल एंड ज्वाइनिंग देम, दैट इज कॉर्ड। एंड इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस अबाउट द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ कॉर्ड, की कॉर्ड इज अ लाइन सेगमेंट विच इज ज्वाइनिंग एनी टू पॉइंट्स ऑन द सर्कल। नाउ डियर फ्रेंड्स, वी हैव टू डू सम एंड अकॉर्डिंग टू वी ड्रा सपोज दैट ओ एल परपेंडिकुलर टू द कॉर्ड ए बी, एंड वी हैव टू शो दैट दैट परपेंडिकुलर फ्रॉम द सेंटर ऑफ द सर्कल टू द कॉर्ड बाइसेक्ट्स द कॉर्ड, मीन्स दैट that line perpendicular divides that chord into two equal parts, means we have to show that AL is equal to BL. And we have to do some construction. We just join OA and OB. This is construction. So you know that very well, ki in proving any theorem, first of all we write given. So first we are in dear students, given, and what is given, let's see. So in given a circle C with center O and radius R, okay, this is represented in this way, this is represented as the circle C with center O and radius R, okay, in which AB is a chord, AP be a chord, and we draw OL perpendicular to AB. OL perpendicular to AB, because of this is given in our theorem ki the perpendicular drawn from the center of the circle to the chord. So in this way, in given, we write a circle C with center O and radius R, in which AB be a chord, and we draw OL perpendicular to AB. Okay, dear students. Now we write lesson to prove we have to show that ki the perpendicular drawn from the center of the circle to the chord bisects the chord, means we have to show that AL is equal to BL. We have to show that AL is equal to BL. Okay, and dear student, we have to do some construction in that figure. What I construct in the figure, we have to construct that ki we just join OA and OB. Okay, we write construction join OA and OB. Joined OA and OB. Now we write what? We write prove na. Yes, we write prove, because of in previous class we already discussed about that topic ki in proving any theorem, first of all we write given, then we write to prove. Okay, to prove, then write construction if any, then write with prove. Now this one, we take both the triangles. Now in triangle ALO, in triangle ALO and triangle BLO, okay, we have what we have, let's see dear friends. OA is equal to OB, H equal to, because of H equal to R, this is the radius of the circle na, because of the distance between the center of the circle to any points on the circle is called its what, radius. So that is radius. Okay, so dear friends, we have in triangle ALO and BLO, we have what, we have OB is equal to OB. This is, we write as H equal to R, H equal to R. Okay, and OL is equal to OL. This is what, common. Okay, and angle OLA is equal to angle OLB. This is each equal to 90, each equal to 90 degree. Thus, let's see here, thus by RHS congruence rule, we have triangle ALO is congruence to triangle BLO. Triangle ALO is called congruence to triangle BLO by the concept of RHS congruence criterion. Thus, by CPCT, means if two triangles are congruent to each other, then by the concept of congruent part of corresponding part of congruent triangles must be equal to each other. So from there, AL is equal to BL. Okay, that is AL is equal to BL. Hence proved. Thus, dear students, in this way we can say that the perpendicular drawn from the center of the circle to the chord bisects the chord. This is a very important theorem related to your chapter circle. So please just do more and more practices of that theorem. Now there's a, we take and solve some important questions of your syllabus based on these theorems. Let's see. नाउ
वी टेक सम इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन बेस्ड ऑन दिस थ्योरम. एंड योर क्वेश्चन इज द रेडियस ऑफ अ सर्कल द रेडियस ऑफ अ सर्कल इज 13 सेंटीमीटर is 13 centimeter and the length of one of its chord and the length of one of its chord is 10 centimeter is 10 centimeter. Find the distance of the chord. Find the distance of the chord. Find the distance of the chord from the center. Now let's see its solution.
Okay, just and this is the question here. This is a very important question here. The radius of the circle is 13 centimeter. Okay, means the radius of the circle is given as, which is what? 13 centimeter. Okay,
and the length of one of its chord. So let us take, first of all we draw a figure circle, and let's take O as center and AB is the chord, and we just join OA and OB. We find what the distance of the chord from the center. So let us take, we draw OL is perpendicular to AB. So from figure It is clear that OL is perpendicular to AB, and that perpendicular bisects the chord that I discussed about that, and AL is equal to BL because of it bisects. Okay, and the length of chord is 10. So AB is equal to 10 centimeters given, that is AL is equal to half of AB because of the perpendicular drawn from the center of the circle to the chord bisects the chord. So that is AL is equal to 10 by 2 NE, 2 5s are 10, 5 centimeter is given. And radius means OA is equal to 13 centimeters given as 13 centimeters. So this is the right angle triangle. Thus, in triangle OLA, so in hypotenuse is OA square using Pythagoras theorem is equal to AL square plus OL square. So we find here from there OL. So OL square is equal to OA square, means 13 square minus 5 square, 169 minus 25, that is 144. Thus OL is equal to under root 144, that is 12 centimeter. Thus this is the required solution of the given question. Thus, dear student, in this way, we can say that ki the distance from of a chord from the center of the circle is what? 12 centimeter. Okay, dear student. So this is the questions based on the previous theorem which we discussed in that class. So please, dear student, do more and more practices of that type of questions. After that, you can solve each and every questions of your NCERT exercise based on these topics. Okay, now we take and solve some other important questions based on that topic, or we discuss some important theorem. Let's see. Discuss some important theorems. This is also very important theorem of your NCERT exercise. And theorem is, if two chords AB and AC, AB and AC of a circle with center O, center O, are such that आर सच दैट द सेंटर ओ लाइज द सेंटर ओ लाइज सेंटर ओ लाइज ऑन द बाइसेक्टर ऑफ लाइज ऑन द बाइसेक्टर ऑफ एंगल बी ए सी ऑन द बाइसेक्टर ऑफ एंगल बी ए सी प्रूव दैट Prove that AB is equal to AC. AB is equal to AC. That is the chords are equal. That is the chords are equal. This is the very important theorems.
Very important theorems related to that chapter, because this is the one of the most important theorem. Okay, let's see. So here there's two chords AB and AC of a circle,
okay, with center O are such that. So first of all, we draw a circle. Let's see very carefully, and we draw two chords AB and AC. So A is common point, so we take that is center.
And that center O are such that the center lies on the bisector of angle BAC. So let us take
this is A. We take as this is point B and this is point C. Okay. Now we just join AB and AC because of there are two chords. This is chord and. And this one, the center lies which, where the center lies, O lies on the bisector of angle BAC. This is angle BAC, and the bisector means we just draw that. So this is the center O, and we just join OB and OC. This is your figure here. So first of all, this is a very important theorem. This is the bisector of angle BAC, means center O lies on the bisector of angle BAC, means that angle. Okay, so this is the question, and we have to show that chord AB is equal to chord AC. So this is a very, very most important theorem related to that topic. Let's see. Now, first of all, we write in given, we write two chords AB and AC of the circle C with center O and radius R such that angle BAO is equal to angle because of this is equal to this angle na because of this is the bisector. So bisector means what? Angle BAO is equal to angle CAO. Okay? That angle is equal to that angle. Because of this is the bisector of angle BAC. So that angle is equal to that angle. Means angle O BAO is equal to CAO. Okay? Angle CAO. This is given in our theorem. Now we write what? Proof. To prove. So what we have to show that? We have to show that the AB is equal to AB means the chords are equal. Have to show that AB is equal to AC. Now we have to do some construction. Yes, we just join OA, OB and OC. In construction, we just join OB and OC. OB and OC. Let's see. So, dear friend, we just join what? OB and OC respectively. Okay. Now look. Now we write as proof. Okay. So now we write as proof. Look, so first of all, we take in triangle AOB. In triangle AOB we have, in triangle AOB we have what? Let's see. Dear student, OA is equal to OB because of each equal to R. In that triangle OA is equal to OB because of this is each equal to R. If OA is equal to OB, then we know that the angle opposite to equal sides are also equal. So that is angle OA. That is angle OAB is equal to angle OBA. Take equation number 1. Okay.
Take equation number 1. Because of here OA is equal to OB, each equal to R, and in triangle AOB, side opposite to equal angle are also equal. Similarly, in triangle AOC, let's see. Here OA is equal to OC. This is H equal to R. That is angle OAC
is equal to angle OCA. We take equation number 2.
Okay, so in this way we draw the second equation. Okay, now look,
this is the second one. Since OA is the bisector of angle BAC, that is angle OAB is equal to angle OAC. Now using 1 and 2, we put the value of angle OAB and angle OAC. Thus okay, this is the value of OAB, this is OAC. So OAB, so now using 1 and 2 and 3, okay, we put the value of, now that is equation number 3. Thus using equation 1, 2 and 3 we get the value of angle OAB is what? Angle OBA. ठीक है, तो this is angle OBA is equal to OAC is what? That is OCA. OBA is equal to angle OCA. Okay, this is equal to what? This is angle OAB is equal to, and this is angle OAC is equal to. So in we have to show that ki what? OBA. OBA is equal to OCA. Is that angle is equal to that angle. Now what I do? Thus in triangle OAB and triangle OAC we have, let's see,
if we take that these two triangles,
then we have what? Let's see, in triangle OAB and OAC, let's see. So OAB angle OAB is equal to angle OAC. Angle OAC, this is given, in this is the bisector, okay, and angle OBA, दिस इज टेक इक्वेशन नंबर फोर, एंगल ओ बी ए, ओके ओ बी ए इज इक्वल टू एंगल ओ सी ए, ओ सी ए दिस इज फ्रॉम इक्वेशन फोर, एंड ओ ए इज इक्वल टू ओ ए, ओके एंड ओ ए इज इक्वल टू ओ ए, दिस इज कॉमन,
दिस इज द कॉमन साइड इन बोथ द ट्राइंगल, दिस इज द कॉमन साइड इन बोथ द ट्राइंगल,
दस बाई एंगल एंगल साइड कॉन्ग्रुएंस रूल, एंगल एंगल साइड कॉन्ग्रुएंस रूल ट्राइंगल ओ ए बी इज कॉन्ग्रुएंस टू ट्राइंगल ओ ए सी, ओ ए सी दस बाई सी पी सी टी, दस बाई सी पी सी टी ए बी इज इक्वल टू ए सी, ए बी इज इक्वल टू ए सी, हैंस प्रूव, हैंस प्रूव,
तो दिस इज द प्रोसेस टू प्रूव दैट थ्योरम, तो दिस इज वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थ्योरम ऑफ योर सिलेबस, सो प्लीज लिसन टू मोर एंड मोर प्रैक्टिसेस ऑफ दैट टाइप ऑफ थ्योरम.
लेट्स सी वंस मोर टाइम, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल we take do both the triangles OAB and OAC, and first of all we take triangle OAC, and in that triangle let's see OA is equal to OB, H equal to R, then we know that the angle opposite to equal sides are equal to each other, so from there we write angle OAB is equal to angle OBC, we take OBA, we take equation number 1, similarly we take triangle AOC, similar if we take triangle OAC then again we apply the same concept, which is what, ki OA is equal to OC, OA is equal to OC, why, H equal to R, H equal to R, if that equal to R then again in that triangle that angle is equal to that angle, because of we know that the side opposite to equal angles are also equal, so again angle OAC is equal, now using these two relation we have to show that ki angle OBA, yeah, here let's see angle OBA is equal to angle OCA, now after that what I do, so after that we take triangle OAB and O A C, O we take triangle O A B and O A C. So if we take these two triangles, then we have to show it. Then we have, let's see, O A B is equal to O A C because of these are the given, because of here the center of that circle is situated at the bisector of angle B A C, bisector of angle B A C. So this is the bisector. So that angle is equal to that angle, it is already given ki angle OAB is equal to angle OAC, okay, now equation 4 from equation 4 we have to show that angle OBA is equal to angle OCA, so here we write OBA is equal to OCA, then again from equation number 4 and from figure that side is common, OA is common to both the triangles, thus in this way by angle angle side congruence rule that OAB congruence to triangle OAC, so thus by CPCT AB is equal to AC, means the chords are equal, hence proof, so this is the theorem, so please revise one more time that this is the one of the most important theorem of your syllabus, now in next class we take and discuss some important theorem of your syllabus, okay, now thank you all.